Hi, I'm Lou with another episode of My Car Story, and today I'm with John McConaughey, which means you're going to see a great car. John, what year, make, and model is this one?
This is a 1955 Studebaker Commander.
Four-door.
Four-door.
So let's take a look at this one. We're out in the western suburbs of Illinois, and this one, well, it's also a survivor. John, are you the, what owner are you? Are you the second owner of this?
Second owner of it.
Second owner. And how long have you had this one?
I've had this one about 12 years.
Wow. So the first owner was a woman who decided that she would drive this up until 2001. Mm-hmm. And what drew you to this car? Come on along with me.
It clearly, was just, I was looking at another car from a guy, and I saw this one and just kind of fell in love with it. It was something different.
That's one of the things that you like. I know your grandfather got you into cars, but this is definitely different. There's some cars that you go, wow, and this car's got a little bit of the, what I call, what in it, where you look at it and you go, what is that? Well, this is a Commander, and it's not just a Commander, but this is the Regal Commander, and that's because it has all the extra chrome. Yep. So you can see that there. We'll show you that as well. We'll show you the interior. We will turn it around for you. But notice it's got this edge up here that you might not notice right off the bat. That great curved glass, your ventilation here, these straight up hubcaps here that you can see. There are some upgrades to that. And this very almost, you know, take this the right way, has kind of a fish carp-like mouth to it open. In that big Studebaker S, just like that. How do you open the hood? Is it underneath?
It's underneath.
Oh, right there. Okay. Not too complicated.
And then you have to put the.
Yeah. You know, it definitely has that 57 Chevy kind of and Ford Thunderbird headlight to it, right there. Now you got to remember, this is before those, even though there was a 55 T-Bird, of course. Did this all come with the car?
No, that tag.
Okay, all right. I was gonna say, my goodness. But look at this, how clean. Now, what do we have? We clearly got a V8. What's the cubic inch on this?
This, if I remember right, is a 340-something.
Okay.
Let's call it the Bearcat.
The Bearcat. You know what? Our viewers will show us, and I'll do a little research as well. Is this an oil bath? Cleaner, it says.
Yep.
Yeah, I see it there. I know that people are saying, Lou, it says it right there. Well, you're going to see it before I did because it was, you had the benefit of the camera looking close. Six volt. Six volt. I see all that there, and you'll hear it crank. And when you hear it crank, you'll know it's a six volt. There's the Bearcat that you see. Your wiper motor. And I can see that writing on top of there as well. You'll also notice the firing order here, like so. And it just, I mean, everything's so original. Look at even paint missing up there. Just looks great. Well, let's fire this one, shall we? We'll let it idle. We'll give it a little rev. Wait till you hear the crank. Didn't give me much of a crank at all. Started right up. Nicely done. Can you step on the brakes for a second? There's our tail lights. We've got exhaust here. Go ahead, give it a rev. Nice. Your single exhaust. And we're gonna turn it around for you. And this Studebaker, well, you could see it's the Commander with the 8. I like how they did that. So design stylish. And you'll see this too, how this works. That actually kind of goes over there. And we'll see how that twists. It has nice little baby fins. I'll show those from the side. Like so. Let me do that. The sun's hitting it just right there. Let's open the trunk, shall we, John?
Okay.
You can see the gas obviously goes in here, like so, with that big loping door. Now, we've got great trunk and treats for this one. First of all, you've got the Leaders in Style, new champion, new commander, new president. Everybody's looking at the Studebaker, and this is an original document, so I'm gonna be very gentle with it. There we go. I'm gonna just move it over to the center. Very gentle. There's your chrome there. Here's your four-door. That's the president four-door. Like so. The word president. Then we go to the next page. Easy. There's your commander. Here's the one that we have here with the chrome package on it. The Regal four-door, they call it, versus the sedan for six passengers. The two-door looks great. Look at how much joy she's having in that one. Now, was there a different engine in this one than the President?
The President, this one had the same engine. The lower one, the Champion,
this is the Champion
had a six
here.
In it.
Got it. So here's the Champion. You can see how plain that looks compared to what we're driving today. She's not as happy driving this one. Truth be told, she's just like, yeah, okay. And then, I don't know if I've ever seen a wagon that has like a Nomad look to it with the two doors. But that's why we like looking at the trunk and treats, so that you could see something just like that. Go ahead, just help with that. Pull it from it. Yeah, thank you. I'm gonna be very careful. Look at that. How happy is she in that car? It looks like a taxi. There we are motoring down the road. And the air ventilation through the seats as we wrap that one up with the Dynamic New Expansion Program. Here's your accessories for motoring pleasure. The best Studebaker cars. Your different radio options, your antennas, the different fabric on the seat covers. Talking about the different types of seat covers, your wheel covers, exhaust deflector, Nomar guards, your custom caps, your luster seal. Now, was this car restored or?
No, this one's pretty much original.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
I'm basically only the second owner.
Electronic clock, Kleenex dispenser, custom designed luggage, safety door locks. There's your automatic fresh air heating, defrosting, ventilation. It shows complete engine protection all the way from the plant. That's great. Your Studebaker 55. Needles and numbers. We'll go through all of that. Is your build sheet?
That's the build sheet.
Wow.
That the Studebaker Club. From them.
Wow, cool. Your dealer service policy, preparation for new vehicle retail delivery, the Studebaker radio, Micromatic tuning radio tubes, owner's manual. I'm gonna pull these off the wall, but I didn't want you to miss these ads either that were on the wall, so we'll add that. And there they are coming off the line. That may even be his car. And there you could see That just looks great. The family and the authorized Studebaker. And then this one here too. The Flying Fortress. How cool is that? So I'll just take you there, and we'll go to the interior. So as I open it up, first of all, you could see the stripe of chrome right down that door for the back, separating it. The level of detail there. You have your back door. Very basic. You've got your smoking back here. Your back window. Your door handle. Wow, service record from way back when. Let me have you look at that. That looks great. You see the sun with the weave and the material right there. I'll show you that. The other important thing is right there is your badge for the car. See if I can get a little closer. You got your venting, your heat, this big commanding wheel. You have kind of a bullseye-like centerpiece there. Now this is $138,000
or? Nope, $38,000.
What?
Yep.
Wow. That's crazy. Wow. That's just crazy. Looks like it had the spot for the four-speed and they didn't put it in there. And then your ashtrays. Looks like your radio.
Oh, I have to check your brake fluid.
Which one?
The cap on the...
Oh, really?
Yep.
Right here?
Mm-hmm.
To check your brake fluid?
Yep.
I thought that would be where a four-speed would come out. That's interesting. And then you've got your park neutral. Pretty nice and basic in here. It's got that piece that comes out there. Well, the only thing left is we're going to take it for a ride.
Okay.
Let's go. Join our ride. I just wanted to mention you've got the Studebaker there that you can see nicely with the sun hitting it right in there. And as I jump in, the other thing I want to just show you, it's got a great sound there. And notice the word Studebaker in the dials, like so. Let's take it for a ride.
Okay.
Now you were sharing this one, you've driven it some distance. Where did you drive it to that one Studebaker show?
It was the main Studebaker show in Indiana.
Yeah.
At the old, by the old Studebaker plants and everything.
Were they excited to see it because they don't see many four doors?
They don't see many four doors, yeah. They were kind of thrilled with it.
It's kind of funny, the one that we used to kind of throw out is the one that caught our attention, right?
Mm-hmm.
Listen to that chug. That's great stuff right there. I'll show people where we're driving to. What's the reaction when you drive this one?
Well, they don't know what it is, first of all.
Yeah, okay.
And then they think, you know, they think it's too modern, because if you put it next to another 50s car, it does look more streamlined and everything.
Yeah.
Than the Chevy at the time or that.
Yeah. This road, I just want to show people, there's that jet pointing and figuring out which direction we're going. Look how nice this one goes down the road. This is just a nice, clean, reliable car. Wasn't the bottom of the line, wasn't the top of the line. Just a nice middle-of-the-road car.
Yep.
Kind of like your Chevy Bel Air. Was it the Biscayne, or was it the Impala?
Well, earlier the Bel Air was the top of the line.
Yeah.
Was the 210 underneath it?
Yes. Boy, she took great care of this car.
She did. I mean, I don't think she did. I mean, see by the mileage, she didn't drive it much.
No, not much miles. Literally a car to Sunday driver, as you call it.
Yes.
It's just so much fun to be in. It takes you, and with this road, it takes us right back to 1955. This is just great. I really hope everybody's enjoying this. I'm looking forward to hearing the reaction. John, always a treat to see you. So many fun cars that you have. Thanks for sharing them with us. Thanks for being at My Car Story.
Sure. Thanks for having me.
You're welcome.